Hey everybody, your old friend Razmi is back, and we're going to talk about a man by the name of Solomon Kane. Yes, Solomon Kane, the original Puritan badass. The original Ghostbuster, if you may. Solomon Kane was created by Robert E. Howard, the same author who inspired the mythical tales of Conan the Barbarian. And today, we're going to look at some of his comic books. Oh yeah. Give me a moment to get ready. See my trusty adventure hat. Good old flintlock. And my sword of Puritan steel. Let's get started! Right off the bat, things are off to a shaky start. The cover looks, I don't know, weird, almost amateurish. And Solomon Kane looks like he's 50 years old with bad facial surgery or something. Also, it says Red Shadows Part 1 and Issue 1 of Solomon Kane, yet there's this little blurb on the inside cover saying Number 10 in a series. What's up with that? In a hue, we are greeted with much better art, in my opinion, and a page that honestly would have made a much better cover of Solomon Kane fighting a horde of demons. Yeah, he's kicking their asses and taking their infernal names, but it turns out to all just be a dream. The boy from a nearby village wakes up Solomon Kane and warns him that one of the roads is haunted by a flesh-eating ghost. Naturally, Solomon investigates.
Solomon Kane! He ain't afraid of no ghost!
However, unfortunately for our hero, it turns out the rumors of the haunted road are true. Solomon is promptly attacked by a vicious, flesh-eating ghost. He puts up a good fight, but unfortunately gets his clock cleaned. He lets out one last prayer to God, and this seems to terrify the vicious, evil ghost. The power of Christ compels you. Who would have thought that actually worked in a story? Solomon manages to escape and, I kid you not, manages to burn the ghost with a shadow of two branches that just happen to form a symbol of the Holy Cross. The ghost retreats back into a tree and Solomon Kane falls down ready to die of his wounds. However, he is rescued by the village boy from earlier and taken to a hut belonging to an old miser named Ezra. Ezra tells Solomon about the time his cousin went crazy, tried to kill him, and stole all his gold, and then sank into some quicksand. Odd. I wonder if he tells that story to everyone who just happens to stop by. Our hero is awoken in the middle of the night by yet another spooky ghost, and discovers that Ezra is actually lying. It was he who stole the gold and murdered his poor cousin. Ezra finds out that Solomon found out, and they all found out about finding out, so they fight. Solomon Kane goes all Batman in the situation, kicks his ass, and solves the mystery in that the ghost is actually Ezra's murdered cousin. Justice has been served, and the spirits now rest in peace. Oh, and yeah, it turns out the village boy was the ghost. But nobody saw that coming. And so our comic ends on yet another awesome splash page that frankly should have been the cover.
Next month, Red Shadows.
Wait a minute, Red Shadows? I thought this was Red Shadows. It's called Red Shadows Part 1 of 4, yet this story is never mentioned or brought up again in the following three. In fact, the next three should have been called Red Shadows Part 1, 2, and 3, and this should have just been called Solomon Kane and the spooky swamp moor ghost thing. The next three covers are all equally bad because none of them come close to matching the interior art, and they're all equally very misleading, often depicting stuff that does not happen in the issue. I hate it when comics do that. You have to judge a comic by its cover, because that's all you got. You don't have a cool little thing on the back that says, oh, in this issue, here's what happens. You don't get that. Anywho, the story proper starts when Solomon Kane finds a young dying girl, not a withered, zombie-like, mummified corpse. And she tells her tragic tale of how her village was massacred by bandits led by a man named Laloop. She soon dies, and Solomon, apparently having nothing better to do with his weekend, vows to avenge her.
Jeez, I thought Batman was a little heavy on the revenge!
I don't want to give away too much, so I'll go over these next three issues quickly. Solomon chases the bad guys nearly all over Europe, killing them off one by one until finally only Laloop remains, their charismatic leader. You know, it really says a lot about Solomon's character. He's never met this girl before, yet he's willing and able to go through all this trouble and expense to see that justice is served. Frankly, I think that's kind of badass. I love this guy. Anyway, he tracks Laloop all the way to the dark continent of Africa, where he's apparently made friends with tribal savage warlords.
Wait a minute. Guy in a hat and trench coat chasing around some guy halfway across the world who goes by the nickname The Wolf. What does that remind me of? One Piece!
Once again, things take a turn for the supernatural when zombies show up.
Now we here at the Razmir Show don't take too kindly to extreme gore. We like to keep things a little more PG-13, but we also prefer boobs over blood. So this next scene is a little bit on the gory side, fair warning. However, I'm going to do a little bit of touching up with some Photoshop, so the edits should seem seamless.
The zombie doesn't seem to like Laloop either, and thus makes short work of all his warlord buddies by ripping them into tiny pieces. It's pretty gory, but also kinda awesome. Just saying. In the confusion, Laloop escapes, and he has his final showdown with Solomon Kane. Laloop is such a magnificent bastard. I love to hate this guy. Not all villains need to be, ambiguous in morality and, I'm right from my point of view. Sometimes a good story just needs a mustache twirling jackass. And oh man, is it satisfying when he gets his just desserts at the hand of our hero, Solomon Kane.
Solomon Kane wins. Fatality.
That was the first four issues of the Solomon Kane comic. All in all, I like it. I love it. I want some more of it. Though, seriously, get someone else to do the covers. By crumb were these good adventures.
Now, I am not 100% sure how loyal the comics are to the original source material. I've never read the books. But after reading the comics, I sure as hell want to read the books. And if any of the comics and this badass movie trailer are anything like the original books, then heck, I'm excited. So, yeah, I think that's a plus in anyone's category. Also, when the hell is this movie coming out in America? It came out in Europe way back in 2009, so what, they didn't even want to port it over to DVD? What's up with that? Are they waiting for the right time to put it up in American theaters? Cause if the movie's done, why can't we watch it? Oh well, I guess they were too afraid to compete with Batman and the Avengers.
I hope you enjoy Solomon Kane. And until next time, everybody, I'm Razmir.